This video is brought to you by Squarespace. So, it finally happened. After years of keeping us in the dark, Prusa finally released their next generation MK4 printer, to much fanfare. And in this video, I want to share some of my own thoughts as someone who has very openly criticized Prusa in the not so distant past, and also as a longtime fan of theirs prior to that. So grab your popcorn and let's dive in. First, why make this video? Well, as you all know, I've been a huge fan of Prusa and their brand and their products for quite some time, up until recently when I became frustrated with their rate of innovation, their lack of updates, and in retrospect, the fact that they literally made April Fool's jokes out of how eagerly we, their loyal customer base, were waiting for them to come out with something new. And while the diehard Prusa fanboy army immediately decided to label me as the Antichrist, the truth is that I only created my video of criticisms because I wanted to vent my own frustration and to use my platform to express the frustrations of many people like me. And judging from the comments and the like to dislike ratio, I definitely wasn't alone, and I think I hit on a nerve. So you can imagine my delight when this year, instead of posting their tongue-in-cheek thirst trap April Fool's Day joke, Prusa actually released the MK4 and shared a lot of interesting behind-the-scenes information that really changed my perspective. Now, we're going to get into the printer itself, its specs, and what I actually think about it in just a moment. But first, let me say this. Personally, I took Prusa's Wednesday is the New Friday and the timing of this release before April 1st as a sort of repair attempt. A way of saying, hey, yeah, it wasn't cool in retrospect, and this year, we're not going to mess with you guys for a laugh. In fact, the actual April Fool's joke this year, hexagonal filament, was much more in line with what I'd consider to be good humor rather than baiting and teasing and poking at wounds of the eager customer base. But more importantly, with the release of the Mark IV, Prusa also revealed a blog post with a lot of new information about its development and the last few years of secrecy that really changed how I and probably many of you see a lot of the things that were so upsetting before. Take, for example, the survey that they did on printables just a few short months ago. I, like so many others, was outraged at that survey because I thought that it meant that they were just now getting serious about the development of the Mark IV, only after Bamboo came along and gave them a kick in the butt. But instead, last week we discovered that by that time the Mark IV was not only completely finished, having been in development for 3 whole years, but was rounding out over 1 million hours of testing in-house at Prusa. Meaning that this was just a way of them checking in to see that the product was in line with what consumers wanted, and frankly, they were just using an age-old marketing tactic of getting people engaged and invested in the product by letting them feel that they had a say in its development. Now, it would have been nice if they had used this well-known strategy in the way that someone like Jeff Walker teaches it and stated clearly that, hey, we're just putting the finishing touches on the product and we wanted to make sure that we didn't miss anything, but whatever, fine. Regardless of how they did it though, this newly revealed timeline changes everything and it sheds new light. Now, we realize that instead of just sitting on their butts, Prusa was just being incredibly thorough, cautious, and secretive. I'm not sure why though, as a company that prides themselves on open source and transparency, why did they feel that they needed to be so secretive about the development of this product? I mean, even Apple, the most secretive company on earth, pretty much releases the iPhones on a predictable schedule, but they felt the need to do that and that's their prerogative. But Prusa also went further to answer many of the gripes that I expressed in my video. Not that I'm claiming that they were answering to me directly, but just that they were in fact listening to their customer base all along, even though it certainly didn't feel like it over the last couple of years. First of all, they lowered the pricing back down on the Mark III and made it so that the Mark IV is barely more expensive. They are now focusing on selling pre-assembled printers to be more competitive with the experience of someone like Bamboo. And perhaps best of all, they launched this product with 1,000 units in stock and ready to ship, which not only breaks the reputation they've developed for launching to endless pre-order waitlists, but also one-ups a lot of other competitors that have endless back orders. Though admittedly, they did sell through the stock within a few hours, and they allowed the XL customers to change their order and jump to the top of the line, so we are back to an 8 or 9 week back order for many people. Regardless, all of this is fantastic, and they deserve to be commended for it. My original gripes were all about being detached from the reality going on in the marketplace, forgetting about their loyal hobbyist consumer base, and being deaf to our desires. And all of this proves that the reality is anything but. But what do I actually think about the printer itself? I mean, it's still a bed slinger. It's evolutionary, not revolutionary. Almost all of its innovations have already been done by other people. Oh, and it's expensive. All of this is true, but I think we need to look at the big picture and look at this information in context. First, let's talk about the fact that it's a bed slinger, which evolves the i3 platform rather than going to Core XY. While that's a bit disappointing, and I would love to see a desktop-sized Prusa printer that competes with the Bamboo X1 Carbon, I've come to the conclusion that this just isn't that product. In fact, I saw a tweet from Joseph Prusa himself, which stated as much. If you read between the lines of this tweet, you come to realize that the Mark IV is Prusa's way of making good on their promise to provide an upgrade path for their existing 350,000 i3 printers out in the wild. Now, this is a long-standing part of their ethos, and it's something that their customers expect and demand from them. They just had to do it, and they did. And this upgrade, whether you go for the highly reasonable $249 option or the admittedly pricey $580 version, will give you another 5 years of life from your printer and keep it up with the Joneses, so to speak. And if Prusa hadn't gone and done this option, then they would have soured a lot of their existing fan base. What's more, though I haven't actually seen or used the product myself yet, I will say that even with the admittedly inferior bed slinger design, they are claiming quality, speed, and performance that is comparable to many Core XY printers out there, which in and of itself is a pretty impressive accomplishment. And let's not forget that Prusa already does have a Core XY printer on the market, their top-of-the-line flagship XL. And you better believe that they are using that product as a platform for testing and developing their next desktop printer. This reminds me of how a lot of car companies like BMW and Mercedes use their flagship products at the top of the line to test out new technologies before trickling them down to the rest of the product line. Does this mean that we're guaranteed to see a Core XY desktop printer from Prusa in the next few years, or that the Mark IV is the end of the line for the i3 platform? I'm not sure, but I certainly hope so.
All right, hang on 1 second, because I just have to interrupt my own commentary and my vacation to take a moment and say that one of the things that I think that Prusa did so well this time around was that they had their website updated and set up and really ready for all the e-commerce and customization, because they have spent like years developing their own custom e-commerce platform. But that's extremely expensive and difficult to do, and most companies can't and won't do that. And that's as good of a segue as I can think of towards thanking this video's sponsor, which is Squarespace. Now, I have used Squarespace products for years, including Squarespace scheduling, and I love how incredibly easy it is to use. But I unfortunately do not use their website builder, which is why I hate building my website and working on it. Don't be like me. Use Squarespace. It's a whole lot easier, whether you need to build a portfolio, a normal website, or, pertinent to this video, an e-commerce website with things like inventory and more. So, to support this channel and check out Squarespace, you can sign up for free at squarespace.com, and when you're ready to launch, go ahead and visit squarespace.com/thenextlayer and use coupon code THENEXTLAYER as you're ready to launch to save 10% on your purchase of a website or domain. Thank you for all of you supporting Squarespace, because they support me and allow me to make all these videos for all of you. All right, let's get back into the analysis.
But Jonathan, some of you might be saying, it's too little too late. Bamboo is already here. And to that I say, yeah. Prusa is facing some very steep competition, and there's no doubt that companies like Bamboo are eating into their market share big time. But I wouldn't start writing their obituary just yet. Far from it. In fact, I've come to realize that despite how many people are comparing Bamboo Lab to Apple in terms of the fit and finish and user experience of the actual products, when it comes to product development and philosophy, it is in fact Prusa that is very similar to Apple. Yes, other companies integrate the latest technologies into their products much faster, sometimes even years in advance of Apple or Prusa. Both of those companies take their sweet time, almost to the point of becoming laughingstocks when they actually do it. But when they do it right, based on years of research and testing and watching competitors go through all the mistakes, flub-ups, and so on. Heck, the iPhone didn't even get copy-paste, widgets, or dozens of other features until years after the competitors had already successfully integrated them. But when they did, Apple got it right the first time. Now that's not something that every customer is willing to tolerate, but to Apple's customer base, they appreciate it. And I think Prusa is a lot like that as well. They aren't in a huge rush to be the first to integrate new technologies such as using the nozzle to level the bed, or planetary gears, or wireless connectivity. But when they do get around to implementing them, they do it in a way that just works, based on a lot of in-house testing. And if you consider that Prusa's primary customer base is either hobbyists who want one printer that they can depend on indefinitely on the one hand, and print farms that just can't afford for their printers to go down all the time on the other, this makes a lot of sense. I have a lot of good things to say about my Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon, and I truly love it, but there are still a lot of bugs and kinks that need to be worked out. Not to mention years of proving that it can be as reliable a workhorse as the Prusa printers already are. Okay, fine. But what about the price? I mean, at the end of the day, say what you will about the Mark IV, it is still an $1,100 open bed slinger with printed parts in an era where just $100 more can get you a fully enclosed Core XY Bamboo Lab X1. And the bamboo prints faster. Yes, on paper, all of that is true. But again, you see, looking at just the two products on paper fails to consider the bigger picture. It's like saying that nobody should buy a BMW or a Mercedes because you can get a faster Toyota or Honda for much less money with newer technology in it. But the owner experience of each of those products is completely different. Let's face it, Prusa knows that they cannot compete on price, even though they've done a reasonably good job keeping the Mark IV below the price of the X1 Carbon. Being a European company, they either could move production overseas, laying off hundreds of workers and disappointing their entire client base, or they themselves could in turn do something that their competitors will struggle to do. Sure, other companies like Bamboo can create comprehensive ecosystems of software, hardware, filaments, and pre-tuned profiles. But most other companies can't rigorously test their product and their print profiles for a million hours before releasing it. Most other companies can't provide 24/7 live chat support in half a dozen languages. And most other companies can't and won't offer hassle-free replacement parts or premium service and support experience. Prusa knows all of this, which is why out of 4 minutes and 20 seconds of their promo video, yeah, I saw what you did there, they spent a whopping 2 entire minutes on things like open source, frequent updates, fine-tuned profiles, integration with printables.com, documentation, upgrade paths, and more. Yes, the Prusa is expensive for what it is, on its own. To kit it out with an enclosure, an MMU3, and so on, you are going to spend more money than a Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon combo. But hey, a Mercedes is also a lot more expensive than even the top-of-the-line Toyota. And I'm not saying that because I think Bamboo Lab is an inferior or an economy product. It's still marketed as a high-end product. I'm saying this and making this comparison because at the end of the day, some consumers want a premium product with a hassle-free white glove service experience with all the kinks and bugs already worked out. And if that were the case, there wouldn't be any European auto manufacturers left in the game, and Apple just wouldn't have a business at all. You can defend other companies and their products and say that they're a better value or they don't have that many bugs, but ultimately, those are subjective opinions. Some users will place value on things like brand reputation, open source philosophy, upgradability, customer service, and rigorous testing. And others will prefer the performance and polished design of something like the Bamboo Lab X1. That's the beauty of the free market. We're all free to choose. And no matter which side you go with, you will get a better product because each of these companies is challenged to create and improve the best product. But judging from Twitter and the backlog on Prusa's website already, a lot of people have already chosen to back the Prusa Cam, and myself included. I actually did order an MK4 upgrade kit for my Mark III S Plus right away, and I'm looking forward to not only reviewing it, but also comparing it against my beloved Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon, my beloved Voron 2.4, and some other top secret upcoming printers that I can't even talk about yet. So if you're interested in seeing those videos, then make sure to wipe down that subscribe button with some IPA. Overall, I'll admit that for what it is, I'm impressed with the Prusa Mark IV, or at least from what I've seen of it so far. No, it's not a next generation Core XY monster. No, it's not super affordable, and I'll be genuinely disappointed if Prusa doesn't come out with something more revolutionary for their next generation of 3D printers. But given all the elements and constraints that I've outlined throughout this video, I believe that this was probably the right move for a slower moving premium manufacturer like Prusa Research with such a large legacy consumer base that expects what it does. But what do all of you think? Have I just been sucked back into the cult of Prusa once again? Are you going to order the Mark IV like I did? Or have you left Prusa once and for all? Let me know in the comments below, but please remember to keep it respectful because ultimately this is a hobby and we're all just here to have fun, build relationships, and express our creativity. So there's really no need for tribalism or name calling. Thanks for watching, liking, and subscribing because it really does make a difference. And a special thanks to my Patreon supporters who are helping me, hopefully, fingers crossed, rent a studio space very, very soon. That's all for now, but I'll see all of you on the next layer.